Hello friends, how are you all? Today we are going to see how to easily remove corn kernels from the cob and three easy road style corn recipes, which is absolutely kid friendly and it is a perfect evening snack. So come on, let's start making. So before that, let's see how to separate the corn kernels from the cob. So here I am taking a large sweet corn which is not boiled, which is raw. Here I am going to take only one row first. So using a spoon or knife which is not so sharp, try to take out the corn kernels one by one. It will be little messy in the beginning, especially for the first row. The corn may break, but that is completely fine. Keep doing. So you can see the first row corns are little messy and it is not coming out properly. From the next row it will come out nicely. So the first row has done. Now for the second row, I am just using my hands to separate the corn. No need of spoon or knife, anything. So I am just using my hands to simply separate the corn. See how easy it is. It will just easily come out. You don't need to put much of pressure also. With a little bit of pressure, it will just come out. Even a 3-year-old kids can do this. So instead of buying the packaged one from outside, we can simply buy the corn and we can do this way, and it is so cost effective also. So you can freeze the corn also after parboiling it little, but I am not showing this in this video. So let's see how nicely it has come out. Only the first row it is messy, but rest of the rows it has come out so nicely. Here some of the corn kernels are not so nice, so I am throwing that away. You can separate each and every row in the same way. See how easily it is coming out. So it's almost done. Only one row is left. That's it. So that's it. All the corn kernels has come out except the first row. Rest of everything is nicely came out. Let's start making the recipes. So for this I am going to steam the corn. You can use idli cooker or anything. You can pressure cook the corn also, but I prefer the steaming way. I am adding little bit of water in a kadai and placing a small bowl, adding the washed corn and just going to cover and cook for 10 minutes in high flame. I have not added any salt or anything. So after 10 minutes you can see the corn are so nicely cooked. So instead of pressure cooking, I always prefer the steaming way, which is much healthier than the pressure cooking way. So now let's start making the recipes. So first I am making the buttery corn. For the buttery corn, I am taking little salt, little bit of chili powder, pepper powder and butter. I am giving all the details in the description box as well. So for the buttery corn, it should not be so spicy. It should be really mild and the butter should be more. Now adding 1/4 cup of cooked corn. Here I am taking the chilled butter. When the chilled butter is mixed with the hot steamed corn, it gives a very nice flavor. So mix in completely. That's it. Butter sweet corn is done. It is exactly as like the ones we are getting from the market. So simple, right? So butter corn should be very mildly spiced and with more of butter, which is my favorite. Next we are going to make masala corn in the same bowl. For the masala corn, I am taking chili powder, jeera powder, salt and butter. Here the masala should be little more than the previous one. I am adding little bit of more chili powder here. Same way, mix the cooked corn with the masalas. Here I am taking 1/4 cup of cooked sweet corn. Mix it completely and you can transfer to the bowl and you can just serve, nothing else. Just take 2 minutes to do this. So masala corn is ready now. So here you can literally see the masalas are little more than the previous one, and you can add little bit of chili flakes if you really want to. My husband prefers to add little bit of chili flakes, so I have added. Transfer to a small bowl and it is ready to be served. Next we are going to make cheesy corn, which is my son's absolute favorite. Here I am taking 3 tablespoons of grated cheese, salt, Italian herbs and rest of the corn. Taking a pan, adding some butter. Let the butter melt. Don't brown the butter. Add the Italian seasoning and chili flakes. Give a mix. Keep the flame to the lowest, otherwise that may burn. Saute for a second. Then I am adding the rest of the corn, about 1/4 cup of corn. Just saute for a minute. Adding salt. Here be careful with the salt because butter has salt, even the cheese has salt. So we need to be really careful with the salt. Now adding 1/4 cup of boiled milk. Let the corn cook in the milk for about 2 to 3 minutes. Now I am adding the cornstarch slurry, which is 1 teaspoon of cornstarch mixed with 1 teaspoon of water, and I am adding to the corn, so it gives the thickness to the corn mixture. So keep mixing. You can see the mixture will start to thicken up. Once it start to thicken up, you can add the cheese. I'm just adding the normal regular cheese. And bit of chili flakes and Italian herbs, which gives a very nice Italian flavor. Then cover and let it stay in the lowest flame for 3 to 5 minutes. All the cheese has melted. Now give it a good mix so that the cheese spreads evenly. That's it. The cheesy corn is done. So yummy, and it is so cheesy. And corn, when mixed with cheese, it gives a very nice flavor. Try and let me know how it turned out for you. You can send the pics to me in my Insta handle. I'll be more happy to see. Thank you so much.